Hey everybody, today we will talk about Heptabase and how it really catched up with NotebookLM and even Mem. And I ditched Mem a long time ago for Heptabase, but I've been also using NotebookLM for a long time, make deep research on the knowledge base that I provided. And Heptabase was missing AI features for a long time. They had an AI chatbot in the beginning and then they removed it. And if you follow us and you watch the podcast episode where we interviewed Alan, the founder of Heptabase, years ago, they said if they implement AI, they want to make it properly and it should be useful for the people and not just a simple chatbot. And that's exactly what they did. The moment they started adding AI, it was actually leveraging Heptabase. And in this video, we will do a comparison how good it actually is between the NotebookLM and if the research is actually comparable. And if you look into my ICOR, you see I have integrated Heptabase in my PKM area. If we click on it, we see that many people are using it. Here's the community discussions going on. And I have here attached NotebookLM. Okay, so it is one of my utility apps, NotebookLM, along with ChatGPT and Claude. So NotebookLM is here. We see that 13% of our members are using NotebookLM. So when we go to the ICOR tool finder, you see Heptabase is on the top when it comes to how many users are using it. And then we see ChatGPT is next. When we look for NotebookLM, we see, well, still 38 people are using NotebookLM and they use it for personal knowledge management. And interestingly, a few of you are even using it for personal knowledge project management and business project management. But now let's go into the comparison of Heptabase versus NotebookLM and how good it really is. So here we go. I mainly used it with this notebook here, which has 127 sources in there. So you see, I was using it. And this is mainly cornerstone YouTube videos and articles from Paco, our co-founder, to have the knowledge about ICOR. But there's also the whole ICOR journey book, the book that we publish and that this is on Amazon, and many of our podcasts. So I can literally ask anything about ICOR here and I should get a really good answer. For example, what is the capturing beast? And here we go. It gets the right answer. Based on the sources provided, capturing beast is a core mental model and workflow within the ICOR methodology, which is correct. And then it gives me all the things and the sources. I can click on it and it shows me the sources there. And when I hover it, I get the sections as well where it got it from. And this is amazing because this way I could get now a starting point. I can ask a question that maybe a community member had and get an idea about the video I want to make about this or to write a proper answer and things like that. The thing is, it is limited to what I provide in here. So if people start throwing everything into one notebook, it can become messy. And this is what we say with any personal knowledge management system in general. How the heck should AI figure out what you want if you don't provide proper structure? And I know one or two things about the process behind this database collection when it comes to vector databases and embedding. So when we go again to the myICOR app, we have our myICOR coach here. And here we can also ask questions. What do you think about Notion versus Heptabase? It leverages what tools you have in your tool stack. And then you get answers like this. And then you have here PKM. And when you click, you go to the relevant lesson. And there we have a glossary system. When you hover over an item, you can click and read about it. Then you have the related lessons. You see, there's a deep integration in myICOR where all the knowledge is interconnected and things like that. And AI can then perfectly leverage this for you based on the things that you do. And it gives you the right recommendations to go for or the tools that you're using and so on. And this is a similar way we are using it here with the REC system compared to what NotebookLM is doing. And now Heptabase is doing too. Okay. So it is always the question to what extent this works. And again, the more you narrow things down, the easier for AI it will be to give you the proper answers. But obviously we want to throw as many things in there to get the best answer possible. And you see, we have all these amazing things in NotebookLM, like an infographic, slide deck, data table, all these things. Obviously, guys, when I go to our podcast where Paco and I talked about the release of the AI in Heptabase, you guys got in there and some of you really, killed. Heptabase doesn't even come close to NotebookLM in accuracy and capabilities when adding 50 large sources. I unsubscribed from the channel. Lots of hyperbole and clickbait and misinformation here. Yeah, well, sorry that you see it this way. The thing is, it's always coming down to what you need it for, obviously. And if you have a specific use case, then it doesn't mean that Heptabase literally kills NotebookLM. Every tool has its own use case. And therefore, NotebookLM will always excel in these vast knowledge understanding. But what I really meant by killing, it killed it for me because what I need, Heptabase is providing too. Let's put it to the test and let's make some simple testing. So first of all, here we are in my personal Heptabase. And the way we structure, and we have the Heptabase Mastery course, and we also have the Heptabase like a Pro course in my iCOR, where we show how we set up Heptabase, okay? So this is just a comparison test here, but these are the only three whiteboards that I have in Heptabase. My projects, key elements, my topics, this is what is the Capturing Beast all about, so I immediately know where to place stuff, and if I go into key elements, now you see my personal things, and I have my health. And this is a personal knowledge management system where I gather information over time. And then I want to ask AI specific questions about something that I gathered over time. It's not a research project. It's a lifelong knowledge capturing that I'm doing here that I'm now able to leverage AI with in order to figure things out better. So for example, if I go to my roles, there's, you know, being a friend, being a husband. And now I could go into this whiteboard and ask AI questions about this specific whiteboard without the need to go to NotebookLM and upload any things, you know, that I had in my personal knowledge management system. Whereas on the other hand, if I would try to use NotebookLM for this, this is messy. This is not an organization like a PKM system. Yes, you can create notes and things like that, but there is a lack of structure. And that's what happens also for Mem. To me, there is lack of structure. This is not easy. Here, I always need to rely 100% on AI that it will find what I'm looking for, versus in Heptabase, I start with the structure and AI uses the structure then to give me the perfect answers and point me into the writer's description there. So I built in my ICOR application. And of course, this started again with just a note. But if you go down to the info section, we see whiteboards here, myICOR 2.0. If I click, here's the whiteboard that shows me how I built the myICOR application. And here you see, it looks like scattered information, okay? There are different boxes around here, but all of these have mentioned something. So if I switch on the show mention link, boom, I see the connections. It is purposefully building my knowledge base, but now I'm on the whiteboard and I can now go to the chat and just ask a question about the whiteboard. You see the whiteboard is now added here. And now we have this specific notebook like we have in NotebookLM, much smoother setup because I did my initial thoughts, I made my notes, all this, and I was building my whiteboard, and now I'm asking questions specifically about it. Whereas in NotebookLM, I would start throwing things in, I can create some notes and save them, but there's no structure at all there. There's just a list of things. And then again, you rely 100% on AI to figure out what is going on here. So let's say here, what features does my iCore provide? Okay, here I can switch between the models. Again, NotebookLM, I'm relying on Gemini, but for the sake of it, use Gemini Pro. So this is what is behind NotebookLM 2. And let's see what is coming up with. And here we go. Okay, the core platform, it's a workstream creator that we have here, multi-company support, ICOR framework integration. We have the unified community, entity discussions, thread visualization, all the things that I have on this whiteboard and to the extent of details that I have in here, the learning growth, the growth assignments, all the things is listed here. But the beauty is now I click on it and boom, it opens up this note where this was mentioned in and where it found it to see how accurate it is. And now I can just simply click here, new card, and boom, I have a new card created. It is now in here. It already is, as we have the references here, you see it's connecting to all the sources that it used in here. And therefore I created purposefully a new card that I can now edit, okay? And if anything is in here that I want to repurpose, I can drag it out. And now I have it like this. So there's another mention that I just created by simply dragging out. And I'm not going into the details how Heptabase Heptabase works, but this is a whole other thing than using NotebookLM, obviously. AI becomes a thinking partner, brainstorming partner, and not a driver of the whole thing. Let's do some simple examples and let's see how good it performs. As I said, I made this whiteboard here that is right now empty. Let's go to YouTube testing. Can add a video here. I can add the link. Boom. Now we have these two videos. Let's do the same for NotebookLM. I create a new notebook and here I can also link a YouTube video. And now we have these two YouTube videos. Something I really prefer in NotebookLM is that I have more sources that I can paste, like the Google workspace. Okay. So I have a lot of information, like our ICOR journey book, for example, is on a Google doc that we have there. So it's easy to use. I also use this in Claude, for example, it's embedded there. And that's something that's currently missing in here. If I try to paste in a Google doc link, it's not working, but it perfectly works in NotebookLM. So let's see if Heptabase will improve this there. This would be really useful. Okay, now we have these two videos there in NotebookLM, but now let's also do this on Mem. And in Mem, again, it is not so easy. So you create a new node and I can paste the video in here and it's not embedding. The way this would work, I would need to go to the video. Then I need to use the extension of Mem and then bring it in here. Maybe I'm missing something here. And if you're using Mem and I'm missing the point, let me know. The moment you make it properly, it adds the link on top and gives you the summary. But there is no embedding of the video. Okay, it's not like that I can watch it. I still need to go here and then it extracts these things and this is it. And it varies from each extraction to extraction. So this is why I'm not even going into testing Mem in this video and focus more on the comparison between Heptabase and NotebookLM. Okay, now let's see what happens if we now ask about myICOR. What is myICOR? And now I expected to use these two sources properly in order to give me a comprehensive answer what it is. And we will ask exactly the same in NotebookLM. Here we have the two resources. Let's go here and say, what is myICOR? So Heptabase already started answering and it already says, based on the attached video transcripts, myICOR is an all-in-one productivity blockchain, blah, blah, blah. It seems correct. It is the two resources. This is the timestamps in the video. So if I click, it jumps into the timestamp where I'm talking about what is shared here. And to me again, this is amazing to have because now I can also use it. I'm not going too deep into this. If you want to see another video where I test more things, I'm happy to do it. But to me, this is already an amazing solution that if I click here that I'm jumping between the different timestamps so I have the full context. Okay, and it seems it's very comprehensive. It explains the social community features, advanced productivity features, AI coach, all the things that I shared in these two videos. Let's see what NotebookLM brought up. So here, when I click, it goes into the transcript and shows me the section in the transcript, which is also very helpful. But I would love now to watch actually the position inside the video. That would be better in my opinion. So I could now see the full context starting at here. To me, the visual representation is not as structured as in Heptabase, but obviously for most, it doesn't matter. And let's see how comprehensive, core purpose and audience, key features and functionality. Well, it seems at first glance that it provided the same feedback. However, again, I like the structure here more. And now I could just simply create a new card out of it and have now this card as a summary. And again, if I click on this section, it will open up the different videos and jumps into the right position of these videos. And if I now activate the mentions, boom, I see this is mentioned here. If I open the video card, you see we have transcripts here too. So if you go to the info, we see all the backlinks where this video was mentioned in. You see, I have a deep integration with an actual personal knowledge management system. Whereas here, I can now save this as a node. It generates the node. And now I have this saved as a node, but so what? Now I still have the connection here, but I'm stuck inside one notebook and I cannot use this in another notebook in new context. Whereas in Heptabase, I can now simply go here and create a new whiteboard, more research. And now I can go in here and bring in the summary that we just had, but with different context. Okay, maybe the polling system that I just created is in here. And now having these two things in here, I can think about the two things. I can connect them with each other. And by manually connecting it, this connection is now also represented down here. See, again, I'm going too much into the details of the features, but this is something we need to keep in mind when I'm talking about how Heptabase killed NotebookLM. I just have a NotebookLM like feature that I can leverage in my actual knowledge base that I'm building based on proper structure, concepts and workflows that is already highly organized. And now I can use AI to leverage this organization in a much better way. And I think for today, this is enough. I could go now into PDF research and all these things as well to check it out. But I wanted to make a point here to show you how I'm leveraging now this new AI and why I'm no longer need to use NotebookLM for that. Also the option that I can use Claude and get different perspectives from different models on my knowledge too. And it is now fully knowledge aware. I have a general chat. So like in Mem, I can search my whole knowledge base. And that's why it killed Mem instantly the moment this feature was available, because obviously Heptabase goes a lot deeper when it comes to knowledge management than Mem. And these are the reasons why with this last publication, it killed NotebookLM, for me at least. Make sure to go to the discussion and let me know how you're using NotebookLM. Maybe some certain features that you are aware that I'm not aware that NotebookLM excels at. We have seen in the beginning when we read the comment that NotebookLM obviously can dive much deeper into a vast knowledge base. I have to test this, okay? It's hard to compare this with each other. Maybe I can make a whiteboard and throw in 50 things and see how it compares. If you want to see a video like this where I'm testing it, again, let me know in the comments below. I'm happy to make a follow-up video, and I catch you up in my iCOR.